Hello and welcome to the JB&M Sports Fanatic channel. Thank you so much for joining me for this video. Make sure if you have not already that you consider liking and subscribing to the channel so therefore you'll be up to date with more NFL content, especially as camp rolls around, preseason, and then the NFL season. Definitely not going to want to miss that, as well as some NBA news, college sports as well. Definitely make sure that you consider pressing the subscribe button. But with that being said, good news for Kwon Alexander. I mean, he's visiting the New Orleans Saints this year. He spent some time with them last year as well, so both sides are familiar in that regards. And so he seems to have interest from some other teams as well that would like to potentially sign him, but still the Saints remain a possibility for him, obviously. That's why he's visiting there. But we'll see, you know, what's important to him in terms of, you know, different factors and scenarios ultimately will come to be determining, you know, where he's going to end up playing. But he should be good to go and right in time, you know, before, you know, when a lot of teams are starting camp and stuff. So that is great news right there for him. And also, he's been cleared from his Achilles injury and is ready for football drill. So absolutely perfect timing there. So that's wonderful to hear. And just going back to his entire career in the NFL, it started off with the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. And during that time, dating back to 2015, from 2015 to 2018, throughout that span, he started 46 of 46 games that he suited up for, and also ended up having 380 tackles, along with 7 sacks, 6 interceptions, and 6 forced fumbles. So he had a tremendous, you know, start with the Buccaneers early in his career up until 2018. He even made the Pro Bowl in 2017. His best statistical season was 2016, in which he had 145 tackles that year, along with 3 sacks, a touchdown, and an interception. So absolutely tremendous there. And then in 2019, he spent that year with the 49ers, along with a little bit of 2020 as well, before playing with the Saints. And during his time with the 49ers, he ended up starting all 13 games that he was suited up for and having 34 tackles, along with 1.5 sacks and an interception and 2 forced fumbles. And then during the time that he did spend with the Saints, the 7 games he did ended up playing, he suited up for as well. So basically all 66 games that he suited up for, he started every single game. And last year, he started all 7 games that he's played for with the Saints, and during that time he was able to accumulate a total of 27 tackles in the span of 7 games, along with a forced fumble and 4 pass defenses. So he's certainly someone that can get after it, get after the football, and a great, you know, guy to have in your locker room. And so I'm excited to see what he's going to be able to do out there. I mean, he's throughout his career, he's pretty much played, you know, whether it's left outside linebacker, you know, whether it's middle linebacker, you know, Mike linebacker, he's definitely, you know, someone that comes in with a tremendous amount of experience and success. So I'm really excited to see how he's going to go out there and look for this upcoming season, especially now that he's recovered from that injury. So hopefully we'll see the Kwon that we saw prior to that injury. And if so, that'd be absolutely great for the Saints this upcoming season, because they're really going to have to rely heavily on their defense, especially with the uncertainty at the quarterback position. But with that being said, thank you guys so much for joining me for this video. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Definitely enjoyed bringing this content to you guys, and look forward to seeing you guys next time.